Hi friends, today we are going to see one more filter structure which is very much effectively used in multi-rate signal processing. The name of that filter structure is two-channel quadrature mirror filter, which is short formally named as QMF. So today we are going to see a two-channel quadrature mirror filter, which we write as QMF. Now this filter is actually very efficient, and hence we use this filter. This filter actually uses digital filter bank. So this filter uses digital filter bank. As we are observing, or we are dealing with two channels, there will be two channels or two separate pathway for the signal to pass. Okay, we know that how many types of digital filters, digital filter bank we have. We have one called as analysis filter bank and one is called as a synthesis filter bank. So we will be using analysis filter bank and synthesis filter bank together to form a quadrature mirror filter. So what I do is, I have an X of N signal with me. I divide it into two sub frequencies. One we called as a low pass frequency component, which passes through H0 of Z, and the second one is nothing but a high pass filter. So in the signal analysis, what I did is I divided the signal into its two components. One is the low pass filter, the second is the high pass. So it is a low pass channel and a high pass channel. So now the signal, if it has high frequencies as well as low frequencies will pass through low pass channel and high frequencies will pass through high pass channel. Now, next, what I do is I downsample this by a factor of 2, because how many channels I have used? I have used 2 channels. So low pass I will downsample by a factor of 2. And high frequencies are also downsampled by a factor of 2. This much is the analysis section. What I will get output as? I will get some two outputs. Let I call this output as XA0 and XA1. A stands for analysis, 0 stands for low frequency, 1 stands for high frequency. I will go to the, this much is the analysis part. It's done. One signal broken into two pieces. Now I'll go to the synthesis part. In the synthesis part, I get two signals. Let's say X0 and XS1. It is not direct connected so far. I'm just saying that I have a analysis section and I have a synthesis section. Now I upsample by a factor of 2 okay, and then I will pass them through G0 of Z and G1 of Z. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add them both. Okay, let's say this to be X tilde of N, that is the output. Now what we will do is we will connect them both. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm having an analysis bank and I'm having a synthesis bank, and we are connecting them together to form a complete quadrature mirror filter. Now quadrature mirror, why it is called, we will see into it. But X of N Why it is called two channel? Because I am dividing x of n into two sub spectrum. One is lower side of spectrum, one is the higher side of spectrum. To select the higher or to make the higher frequencies to pass from channel 2 and not from channel 1, we have set two filters. One is H0 and one is H1. Okay, H0 can be called as a prototype filter, which will pass the lower frequencies and not the higher. Your high pass filter passes the higher frequencies and stop the lower frequencies. Then we downsample by a factor of 2. Okay, synthesis section, upsampling, reverse to that of analysis, then filtering to remove the images, adding and getting x tilde of n. Let us see what is the condition to be met to get x tilde of n equal to x of n. Okay, to achieve that condition, let us do some analysis. For let's say, what will be xa0? xa0, if you apply a downsampling factor, it is given by 1 over d summation, okay, m goes from 0 to d minus 1, okay, x of z, okay, or I will directly write here now, omega by d into h of omega by d. Okay, this is what the factors are. Now what I am going to do, I am going to imply the factors. So the first xao will be equal to, now my d factor is how much? 2. So it will give 1 by 2. Because the summation is running over 0 to 1, there will be how many total entities? 2. So I'll write that entities directly. It is x of omega by 2 into h naught of omega by 2, which is the low pass side, plus x of omega minus 2 pi by d into h of omega minus 2 pi by d. Okay, I have not considered here the shifting of the omega. It is minus 2 pi m. Here also it will be minus 2 pi m. That means the actual inside omega, it will be omega minus 2 pi m by d, and here also it will be omega minus 2 pi m by d. We have not taken into consideration that. I have directly written omega by d because I have written first in terms of z. Okay, so if I write in terms of z, then I have to write as z raised to 1 by d into e raised to minus 2 pi m by d. That when you translate into frequency domain, then it so Fourier domain, it becomes in this way. Okay, so this will not be the case. It will be this as the internal string. Okay, this will be for the case of xa of o. What will be xa of 1 will be equal to 1 by 2 because the input is coming the same way, so it will be the same. Here I will have x1 of omega by 2 plus x of omega minus 2 pi by d into h1 of omega minus 2 pi upon d. Your m is equal to 0, your m is equal to 1. Okay, so these are the two outputs that I will get after the analysis bank. Now, when we connect the analysis bank to the synthesis bank, what happens is xa of 0 becomes equals to xs of 0 and xa1 becomes equals to xs1. If you can see here from the block diagram, I'll show you the block diagram again. If we see the block diagram, if I connect them both, then xa0 becomes equals to xso and xa1 becomes xs1. So I have written xso equals to xs1. Okay, what will be the total output? What will be x, let's say, in terms of omega, if I consider? What will be the total x tilde of omega? So x tilde of omega, x tilde of omega will have two terms because there is an addition into it, right? And what are the two terms? I will have xs of 0 into 2 omega into g of 0 of omega plus xs1 of 2 omega into g1 of omega. Now, how we got this 2 omega? I'll explain you that. We know that xs of omega will pass through an upsampler. Okay, if you consider in terms of z transform, this is xs0 of z, then this becomes xs0 z raised to I, isn't it? So once I say z raised to I, if I put omega, it becomes e raised to j to e raised to j omega I, correct? So I will write omega into I, that is the Fourier domain. So I over here is 2, so I will write 2 omega, right? That is because of the upsampling. Am I sampling the upsampling these things? No, they are just a filter, so I will write it as it is. Okay, now with this upper condition, if I put, then I will have x tilde of omega to be equal to x ao of 2 omega into g omega g naught of omega and xs1 x a1 2 omega g1 of omega, correct? Substitute x a of omega and x 1 a of 1 and replace all omegas by 2 omega is a huge algebraic equation. Will not go into that algebraic equation solution, but I will rather refer to the solution directly. So x tilde in terms of omega, I'll write 1 by 2, okay, I have separated the terms very well, h naught of omega g naught of omega plus h1 of omega into g1 of omega, correct, into x of omega, fine. And I also have plus 1 by 2, okay, h naught of omega minus pi into g naught of omega plus h1 of omega minus pi into g1 of pi the whole into x of omega minus pi. Now see here, this term contains x of omega, right? Whereas this term contains x of omega minus pi, which is shifted by pi values, correct? If I want x tilde to be equal to x of omega, then this term should not be present, right? So this term should go to 0, that is the second term. First term I want, if I want that x tilde of omega to be equal to x of omega, then I don't want the second term. Technically, the first term is the normal term, whereas the second term is the aliased term, okay? So I don't want any aliasing. So if you do quadrature mirror filtering, normally there will be aliasing, okay? So we will have two terms, one is non-aliased and one is aliased. So if I keep both of them, there will be surely aliasing because this will overlap over here. Okay, if omega exceeds certain value, then of course there will be overlapping between these two terms. And there will be, I cannot retrieve x of omega from x tilde of omega, isn't it? So I want the second term to go to 0 and I will retain with the first term. For the second term to go to 0 gives me a condition. Okay, so the second term should be going to 0. So it means that 1 by 2 h naught of omega minus pi into g naught of omega plus H1 of omega minus pi G1 of omega into X of omega minus pi should be equal to 0. What does this imply? This cannot be 0. So this term have to be 0. Okay, so for that term have to be 0, I can say that H naught of omega minus pi G0 of omega plus H1 of omega minus pi G1 of omega should be equal to 0. When this will be equal to 0? When the first term negates the second term, correct? So what condition I will put is, I say that G0 of omega, let it be equal to H1 of omega minus pi, okay, and G and G1 of omega to be equal to negation of or minus of omega minus pi. Okay, so this is, we can prove it very easily. If I put this values, I'm going to get 0. Okay, or this implies this condition. So why I have considered it to be 0? To make the, to avoid aliasing. So if I hold this condition, then I am going to get a QMF, which is aliasing free. If I want aliasing free, or I wanted to eliminate aliasing, then I will make this two condition to occur. If I want aliasing, then this conditions will not occur and this will not go to 0. Okay, so this is called as an alias free QMF filter bank. Okay, so how does the spectrum look like? So if I draw a spectrum of omega versus, I'll not write because there are two spectrums, omega versus magnitude. For H0 of omega, the magnitude comes like this, isn't it? This is for H0 of omega, which is a low pass filter, and let's say it to be normalized to 1. For an high pass filter, this will come up to some point. Let's say for high pass filter, it will be exactly the mirror of the low pass one. So this is H1 of omega, right? The point at which they form the mirror is at pi by 2. Okay, this is up to pi, okay, and this is at 0. So the point at which both the transfer functions or both the responses mirror themselves is at pi by 2, which we called as a quadrature. That's why the name, it we called it as quadrature mirror filter, because we have quadrature symmetricity or quadrature mirror, or mirror is placed at pi by 2, which is quadrature to each other. This is how we design a quadrature phased or a quadrature mirror filter. I hope you have understood what do you mean by a quadrature mirror filter. Thank you.